1 Corinthians 1 and 17, these are the words of Paul, the Apostle Paul, to the Israelites in Corinth. And this is what he said. He said, "For Yahushua sent me not to baptize." Exactly, because when Yahushua came on the scene, water baptism was essentially done away with.
Shalom. Today we're going to talk about baptism. We get many letters from many of you Israelites that ask, do we do water baptism? No.
Mark chapter 11, verse 30. The baptism of John, was it from heaven or of men? Answer me. And they reasoned with themselves, saying, if we shall say from heaven, he will say, why then did ye not believe him? But if we shall say of men, they feared the people, for all men counted John that he was a prophet indeed. We want to give all praises and glory to Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahushai, and peace and blessings to you, brothers and sisters, throughout the four corners of the earth that are waiting on the second coming from our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai. This is Hawa Ya'ala.
Ron, Yahweh.
And we're just going into a lesson just concerning the baptism, you know, and whether or not it was of men or whether it was of the Most High, Yahweh. Okay, so we're just going to kind of touch on this subject because this is something that, you know, brothers and sisters have been mistaught about for decades, okay? And now it's to tear down these strongholds and for brothers and sisters to start examining who are these men that are teaching you, all right, these doctrines and putting leaven in it, okay? So, you know, we're going to go ahead and start off in Matthew chapter 3 and verse 13.
This is Matthew 3 and 13. Then cometh Yahawashi from Galilee to Jordan unto John to be baptized of him. But John forbade him, saying, I have need to be baptized of thee, and comest thou to me? And Yahawashi answering said unto him, suffer it not, suffer it to be so now, for thus it becometh us to fulfill all righteousness. Then he suffered him.
So peep that out. Mm-hmm. He says, suffer it now, for thus it become for us to fulfill all righteousness.
So this act was part of that fulfilling of that righteousness.
Yeah, so Yahawashi did it, so why would his disciples not do likewise?
Exactly.
Would that make any sense? Why would, is Most High the author of confusion?
Absolutely not.
Why would he have his own one and only begotten son that he sent and sanctified on the earth, right? Born of the woman, of the seed of David.
Right.
To come into the world and to do a baptism that is no longer needed.
And it isn't, why wouldn't we try to mimic our Lord and Savior in these in these acts? Isn't he here for an example unto us?
Yeah. And didn't he say himself that any man shall be, cannot be greater than his master, but if he shall be as his master?
That's right.
So why would someone who's fallen after Yahawashi that would want to be as Yahawashi not get baptized? That's unless they feel that they're somehow greater than Yahusha and they are not need of baptism like he was, who was greater than all of us.
Follow in his footsteps.
That's right. And you know, we know some of y'all is hurting right now because, you know, this is something that y'all are not accustomed to hearing.
Exactly.
Because of what you've been taught. But like we say, brothers, y'all have to examine the whole matter. Before you start writing on your comment board and start doing rebuke lessons, you better watch the whole video and then come with your own response.
Correct.
Okay, because we want to make sure that brothers is edified. This is important. We want to get out, and we understand that the only way we can get out is if the gospel of the kingdom is preached the right way, then the end will come. All right, so keep going on.
Verse 16, and Yahawashi, when he was baptized, went up straightway out of the water.
Wait, he came up out of the what?
Out of the water, and lo, the heavens were opened unto him, and he saw the Spirit of the Most High descending like a dove and lightning upon him. And lo, a voice from heaven saying, this is my beloved son, in whom I am well pleased.
Okay, so the Most High was well pleased that he did the baptism.
Exactly.
I mean,
exactly.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that was what he had to do.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
You know, and just like he suffered John to do the baptism, he said this is what he suffered him to do it. So Yahawashi even himself had to humble himself to allow a man that he was greater than to baptize him.
That's right.
For the sake of righteousness.
Yep.
Okay, which is really the right path. All right?
Mm-hmm.
Not, you know, dealing with the straight gate, not the broad. Okay?
That's right.
That's another thing, you know? Because you guys understand, there's only one way through this kingdom. There's one way. There's a righteous way. And Yahweh Shai was showing the way in which we're supposed to follow. So go ahead and start right. for John 3.
This is St. John chapter 3, verse 1. There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The same came to Yahweh Shai by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher come from the Most High. For no man can do these miracles that thou doest except Yahweh be with him. Yahweh Shai answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of Yahweh. Nicodemus said unto him, How can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? Yahweh Shai answered, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of the Most High.
Come on.
Hey, what is that? Repeat that again one more time. Huh?
Except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom.
These are the prerequisites before you can get into the kingdom. You have to be born of water. And what does that entail, Lot?
The baptism.
The that's baptism. Right. You have to be baptized.
Right. In water, man.
In
that's,
water.
That's why right. it says the baptism, the born of the water and of the Spirit. What did Yahweh Shai do in the other chapter we just read? He was baptized in water, and the Father gave him the portion of the whole of his Spirit.
Of the Holy right. Spirit. It descended upon him as a dove, like the scripture said.
That's right.
And that's the second aspect of it.
That's linking up. That's precept upon precept.
That's precept upon precept then.
That's he just showed you mm-hmm. how he got it, and he's giving you the way to get it as well.
Like, yeah, exactly. Right.
Mm-hmm. Okay? It's not because guys come out and they start saying, oh, the water is talking about the scriptures.
And when you see baptism or baptized, that it means exactly what it is. Immersed mm-hmm. under the water.
That's what it means. Yeah,
exactly.
Exactly. Be not overwise. Why shouldest thou destroy thyself?
Right.
You know,
right,
bro. This is playing into the point. And you're going to see, you know, other examples as well. So keep going on that.
Verse 5. Yahweh Shai answered, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of the Most High. That which is born of the flesh is flesh. That which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I say unto thee, ye must be born again. The wind bloweth where it listeth, and thou hearest the sound thereof, but cannot tell whence it come and whither it go. So is every one that is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus answered and said unto him, How can these things be? Yahweh Shai answered and said unto him, Art thou a master of Israel? And knowest not these things?
So here it is. This is a man who is well studied, but he doesn't understand these things. And that's what it is even in Israel today. You have men that are great teachers, but these are things, elemental things that have not been taught and they don't right. understand. And it happened with Nicodemus and it can happen to us.
That's right.
That's why we have to understand what happened with Nicodemus, a guy who was considered a master teacher, like a lot of guys want to be known.
Yeah.
But then when you've examined their doctrine, they don't even understand what? The full scope of the matter.
What we were talking about the other night, that's just like a basketball player. He got the 360 windmill dunk, but they can't dribble.
Yep.
You ain't got the fundamentals down.
Yeah, they ain't got the fundamentals.
That's right.
No fundamentals, man. Like Harold Miner, everybody was like baby Jordan, because yeah. he could dunk. But then when he got to the league, he couldn't get past nobody, couldn't cross nobody over. He had no jumper.
Yeah,
and then he was out of the league.
Yeah,
that's right.
You know, the flashing dash will get you noticed, but it ain't gonna get you into the kingdom, man.
Hey, the fundamentals are required. Look at Tim Duncan.
Yep.
Hey, right. Long career, man.
So you need those principles.
Exactly.
All right.
Verse 11. Verily, verily, I say unto thee, we speak that we do know, and testify that we have seen, and ye receive not our witness.
Come on, man. Mm-hmm. This is, wait, the Gospels was written by men that witnessed Yahweh Shai and everything. Read that again,
Verily, verily, I say unto thee, we speak that we do know, and testify that we have seen, and ye receive not our witness.
Come on, bro. And
fine.
Men are not receiving the witness of men that are apostles.
Exactly.
These are the accounts. This is very elemental things. When brothers say they believe, we got guys out there talking about pushing out Yahweh Shai and the name. Mm-hmm. But then do you believe the accounts and the testimonies and the witness concerning Yahweh Shai and what has been written by people that witnessed him?
Right.
You get what I'm saying? What's use for you to just say the name and say this is the name, but then when it comes to what he did and what his apostles and the scriptures did, and
you negate,
you basically are not receiving of that witness.
Mm-hmm.
Keep going on.
Verse 12. If I have told you earthly things and ye believe not, how shall you believe if I tell you of heavenly things?
Come on, bro. Come on,
bro. That's heavy, bro. That's heavy. Yep.
Going down to verse 18. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of Yahweh.
And in this baptism, you will find that there's a lot of people who do not believe in Yahweh Shai.
Yeah, and that's what we've been saying. It was like the utterance.
Yep.
There has been an utterance. You know, just when us doing the work for months,
yeah,
we've been saying a lot of these guys actually don't believe in Yahweh Shai.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
And it just, as time has went on, just through fasting and praying and seeking diligently the truth of the gospel,
right,
it's been revealed unto us the different aspects that's proving that a lot of these men do not believe in Yahweh Shai.
That's right.
And something like this is going to show a lot of you brothers and sisters who really believes in Yahweh Shai and who doesn't. And brothers that believe in Yahweh Shai, they're going to take heed to these things, and they're going to realize that if they were one of those men back 2,000 years ago, and they were among those men that actually followed in the steps of Yahweh Shai, they're going to realize that this is actually a correct teaching of the gospel.
Yeah, correct. That's right.
And those that don't believe, they're going to continue in the same way.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
So verse 19, and this is the condemnation, that light is come into the world, and men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil.
That's right.
And that's the reason why a lot of these men are not going to come to that light, because they know that their deeds are evil.
That's right.
They're not going to accept this.
Yeah, that's why Yahweh Shai told the Pharisees that they were going to die in their sins.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Because they didn't believe that he was him.
Yeah.
And how do you know? Did they teach the doctrine that he taught?
Absolutely not.
No.
Yeah. And it's going to be made manifest. It's good, you know, and we're going to go further on. Verse 20, for everyone that doeth evil hateth the light, neither cometh to the light, lest his deeds should be reproved.
Mm-hmm.
And this is what's happening. The deeds are being reproved. Men teaching against baptism, your deeds is being reproved. And a lot of them guys going to scatter and like roaches. They're going to not try and address this topic, because they know that their deeds have been reproved.
Right.
By the light of the scriptures, the manifestation of the gospel.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 21. But he that doeth truth cometh to the light, that his deeds may be made manifest, that they are wrought in Yahweh. After these things came Yahweh Shai and his disciples into the land of Judea, and there he tarried with them and baptized. At this point, brothers that are well versed in reading the scriptures, they should know that Yahweh Shai was not baptizing anybody in the Holy Spirit at this point. We're going to read the type of baptism they were doing. Verse 23, and John also was baptizing in Aenon near Salem, because there was much water there, and they came and were baptized.
Much water.
That's why they went in that area. The map is going to show you that there was much water there, and that's where they were baptizing. Plain to the point. Now go to John chapter 4.
This is John chapter 4. When therefore the Lord knew how the Pharisees had heard that Yahweh Shai made and baptized more disciples than John, though Yahweh Shai himself baptized not, but his disciples.
Were they baptizing people in the Holy Spirit, Doc? Or what were they doing?
Baptizing people in water.
Yeah.
They submerged those people in water.
Right.
In the name of Yahweh Shai.
In the name of Yahweh Shai.
That's right.
Come on.
That's it.
I mean, it's plain and simple. So, I mean, you got guys saying that baptism is not needed, but here it is, Yahweh Shai is with his disciples, having these guys baptizing, and then men are saying that baptism was done away with. So that means Yahweh Shai was going off too.
Exactly.
So not only were the disciples going off, Yahweh Shai had to be going off too.
Exactly.
You see how dangerous this is? You see what leaven does?
This stuff is wicked, bro. This stuff is wicked.
Come on, bro.
This is your salvation here, man.
Hey, right. You brothers better take heed to what these men are teaching you, because you're going to realize some of these men are set up, man. Some of these men, either they're, some of these men, their teachers were set up to teach this way, and they stuck in this doctrine, in this mode. And some of these guys are teaching it because they know exactly that they're teaching against the Gospels.
That's right.
Okay? So we're going to go to Acts chapter 2 and verse 36. Therefore, let all the house of Israel know assuredly that Yahweh made that same Yahweh Shai whom ye have crucified, both Lord and Messiah, Mashiach. Now when they heard this, they were pricked in their heart and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Yahweh Mashiach, for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. All right, so like the brother said, that word for baptized is talking about submersion. This is a step in what someone has to take in repentance. Repent and be baptized. What was John preaching in the wilderness? Repentance through baptism and the remission of sins.
That's right.
That's the order. That's how you properly repent. Your sins have to be remitted.
That's right.
Okay, because what's happened is brothers have received knowledge and have not received remission because they haven't acted towards that faith. Baptism is an act of faith.
That's right.
It's one of the first acts of faith that you're going to do as a disciple of Yahweh Shai. That's actually one of the ways, your stepping stones of proving yourself.
Yep.
And the Most High is only going to give that type of faith to the men and women that he wants to choose to do that act. Mm-hmm. Okay? Verse 39. For the promise is unto you and to your children and to all that are afar off, even as many as the Lord our power shall call. And with many other words did he testify and exhort, saying, save yourselves from this untoward generation. Then they that gladly received his word were baptized.
There you go.
And the same day there were added unto them about 3,000 souls.
Look at that.
Plain. Okay, and there's more. So let's go ahead and go to Acts chapter 8.
This is Acts chapter 8, verse 26. And the angel of the Most High spake unto Philip, saying, arise, and go toward the south unto the way that goeth down from Jerusalem unto Gaza, which is desert. And he arose and went, and behold, a man of Ethiopia, a eunuch of great authority under Candace, queen of the Ethiopians, who he had in charge of all her treasure, and had come to Jerusalem for to worship, was returning and sitting in his chariot reading Esaias the prophet. Then the Spirit said unto Philip, go near and join thyself to his chariot. And Philip ran thither to him and heard him read the prophet Esaias, and said, understandest thou what thou readest? And he said, how can I, except some man should guide me? And he desired Philip that he would come up and sit with him. The place of the scripture which he was read was this: he was led as a sheep to the slaughter, and like a lamb dumb before his shearer, so opened he not his mouth. In this humiliation, his judgment was taken away. And whom shall declare his generation? For his life is taken from the earth. And the eunuch answered Philip and said, I pray thee, of whom speaketh the prophet this? Of himself or of some other man? Then Philip opened his mouth and began at the same scripture and preached unto him Yahweh Shai. And as they went on their way, there came unto a certain water, and the eunuch said, see, here is water. What does hinder me to be baptized?
What does hinder him to be baptized? These men.
These men.
That's who's hindering. What doth hinder me to be baptized? You know who's going to do it in this day and age? The same old men that you've been seeing pushing these different doctrines.
That's right.
From their elders down to you, brothers and sisters, refusing for you to be baptized in the name of Yahawashi, which this brother that was coming from Ethiopia to Jerusalem to worship wanted to get baptized and asked, what doth hinder him?
That's right.
These are the same men that I've been pushing these things that do not want brothers to get baptized, because a lot of these men are against the gospels, man.
That's right.
Plain and simple. And you brothers are going to realize more and more, as more and more stuff keep coming out, that these men do not love Yahawashi, man. They do not love the gospel. They do not love the brethren, man. They do not love the elect. And if they want to prove themselves, they better do likewise as Yahawashi and the disciples to show whether or not they're really about this.
That's right.
That's right.
Okay? So keep going, Op.
Verse 37. And Philip said, if thou believest with all thy heart, thou mayest. And he answered and said, I believe that Yahawashi Mashiach is the son of Yahweh.
Come on, bro.
And he commanded the chariot to stand still. And they went down both into the water, both Philip and the eunuch, and he baptized him.
Wait, he went both into the water or into some scriptures? Because these guys keep saying that baptism is just reading you the scriptures and preaching the word only.
He went down both into the water, both Philip and the eunuch, and he baptized him.
Come on, bro.
Look at that, man.
Keep going.
And when they were come up out of the water,
they were come up out of the what?
And when they were come up out of the water.
No, I thought it was coming up out of the scriptures, bro.
And when they were come up out of the water, the Spirit of the Most High caught away Philip, that the eunuch saw him no more, and he went on his way rejoicing.
So when this eunuch went down, when this brother went down to Ethiopia, wouldn't you think and believe that he was baptizing men in the name of Yahawashi for the remission of sins in water?
Oh yeah.
When they believed?
Yeah.
Come on, man.
That's right.
But somehow, some way, it was done away with, and now it's not needed no more.
Man.
Come on, man.
This is Acts 10 and 43. To him give all the prophets witness that through his name, whosoever believeth in him shall receive remission of sins. While Peter yet spake these words, the Holy Ghost fell on all them which heard the word. Verse 45, and they of the circumcision which believed were astonished, as many as came with Peter, because that on the Gentiles also was poured out the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Okay, so now here it is, he's preaching, and the Most High just happened to just have the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit, fall upon the men that were believing.
Yep.
Now they just good to go now. Now they got the gift. They got the Holy Ghost. They probably getting some, they can get some understanding, some wisdom, right? Some knowledge. Were they done yet, Ark?
No, they still have a major step to enter into the kingdom. This is a major step. Verse 46, for they heard them speak with tongues and magnify the Most High. Then answered Peter, can any man forbid water that these should not be baptized, which have received the Holy Spirit as well as we? So we see here, man, that they received the Holy Spirit before they went into the water.
Come on, bro.
Come on, man. My name is Dylon. Fit in this hot fire.
Bro.
Amen.
Hey,
Let's repeat that one more time. Those who have difficulty in hearing.
That's right.
Can any man forbid water that these should not be baptized, which have received the Holy Spirit as well as we?
Man.
Let me keep on. And he commanded them to be baptized in the name of the Lord. Then prayed they him to tarry certain days. So, man, we can drop the mic on this, bruh.
Wait, but according to one of their top teachers that they call an apostle, baptisms in water was done away with. Now, we got to ask you a question.
When?
We need chapter Okay, we need the book, the chapter, and verse mm-hmm. when this was put done away with. Because the Most High is not the author of confusion.
Exactly.
That's right.
Why in the world would apostles be baptizing people in water and all of a sudden not be doing it no more?
Right.
We
right.
need to know when this decree was sent out.
Mm-hmm.
Plain and simple. This needs to be known.
That's right.
That's why Peter asked, can any man forbid water that these men should not be baptized? Mm-hmm. Guess who's going to do it? These same men as before. These same men that got all these lessons on YouTube telling you, forbidding you not to be baptized in water. Why? You got to ask yourself, why are these men teaching these things?
That's right.
They're telling you they've been 20, 30 years in this thing. And they busy calling you brothers babies. But mm-hmm. then if you ask them to break this down, they ain't got nothing to say. Mm-hmm. Are these same men, the same men that conspired to kill Yahushua and his disciples? You got to ask yourself, brothers, because guess what? These men will be back.
Mm-hmm.
Don't think that for one minute that these men ain't going to come back as wolf in sheep's clothing and to deceive the people, even the very elect, if it were possible.
That's right. That's fire, bro.
That's right. This is 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 13. Is Mashiach divided? Was Paul crucified for you? Or were ye baptized in the name of Paul? I thank Yahweh that I baptized none of you, but Crispus and Gaius, lest any should say that I had baptized in my own name. And I baptized also the household of Stephanus. Besides, I know not whether I baptized any other. For Mashiach sent me not to baptize, but to preach the gospel, not with wisdom of words, lest the cross of Mashiach should be made of none effect.
Which is what's happening. Because now the wisdom of words yep. has made the Christ of Yahushua of none effect for these men.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
That's why Gabar, you back at it again. We seen you bring out your foo-foo doctrine on baptism, bruh. You know you twisted the scriptures on this, my man.
That's right.
Don't play games. See, you're the one who uses the wisdom of words to confound the people. This is the kind of God that Paul's talking about.
That's exactly right? Who he's That's talking it. About.
It's guys like Gabar that twist up the scriptures and fortify false doctrine, leaven, to prevent brothers from being baptized.
That's right.
And when Paul was talking about he had baptized, he's talking about those are the people he had physically baptized himself.
That's right.
Because the Most High sent by the Spirit Paul to Corinthians to get a lot of people.
Right.
There were a lot of believers was in Corinthians. He was sent out there, and as the church is increasing, he's not going to be doing as much baptism. Other disciples and brothers that got into the faith will be doing that type of stuff.
That's right.
That's how it works. That's how a discipleship works.
Mm-hmm.
A man is shown how to do something, and the other men carry it on.
That's it.
That's why you think that Paul had to be there the whole time. Men were receiving of the baptism of the gospel of the Holy Spirit and able to continue on the same teachings
mm-hmm.
of Yahushua and the apostles.
That's right. And seeing by you guys, by this guy Gabar doing this, man, he's putting a major stumbling block before you brothers and sisters on entering into the kingdom of heaven.
Yeah.
Because you have to go through, this is a step-by-step process, and this is the first step of it.
Yeah.
And by him blocking it from you, you have no access to the kingdom.
Right? Yeah, a lot of brothers don't even understand that they've been following the broad way, man.
Exactly.
And that including ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's right.
You had to examine the doctrine.
That's right.
Exactly.
Because we want to get into the kingdom.
Yeah.
That's right.
We want to go into the ways of how Yahushua set it up, man. There's only one path, man.
Mm-hmm.
There's only one way to do this, man. Anyone who tries to get in any other way, the same as a thief and a robber.
Yep,
that's right.
And that's what y'all are doing, man. Y'all trying to set up some other way, and the Most High has now removed that spiritual roadblock out the way, and you guys, y'all's doctrine is going to keep going down, man. IUIC, Nathaniel Alaga, Yohanna Barbera, Tahara Shai, all right? Gabar the Sorcerer.
That's right.
Unless you guys repent, the Most High is going to destroy you.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all got to come out of it yourselves, because maybe it was just your teachers over at the Old One West that was giving you that leaven, and you continue that tradition. But it's getting harder and harder to believe, because the more and more we examine it, we've dug even deeper than this.
Mm-hmm.
The more and more we examine this thing, the more and more we realize that the only way someone can go off this much in the doctrine is you have to be doing it on purpose.
Exactly. Right. Exactly.
Because there's no way when you examine the gospel, the principles of the doctrine, the very foundation of it, everything is being taught against. Mm-hmm. And you can only be doing this if you're doing it on purpose.
On purpose.
And you're teaching men to go off on purpose and you're basically fooling them. So brothers and sisters, you got to examine, what are these men teaching?
That's right.
Okay. So this is Sirach chapter 5 and verse 12. If thou hast understanding, answer thy neighbor. If not, lay thy hand upon thy mouth.
That's right.
If you can't answer when baptism in water in the name of Yahawashah Mashiach for the remission of sins was done away with, kayat la boca. Put your hand upon your mouth. Don't say nothing.
Right.
Right, bro.
Don't come with that madness. Don't be all up on the comment board. You're going off, man. Y'all brothers going off. You brothers going off. When was it done away with? If you can't answer that, scram.
That's right.
Repent and be baptized. Mm-hmm. In the name of Yahawashah Mashiach for the remission of sins. We want the brothers to enter into the kingdom. We want the path of the kingdom to be made clear. Mm-hmm. This is not just for us, but this is for, you know, you and your brothers, your wives, your families, your kids.
That's right. That's right.
This is for everybody that believes in Yahawashah and that are earnestly wanting to be delivered.
That's right.
And receive of the eternal blessings of the kingdom that's going to be given to those that believe upon him. Mm-hmm.
Right.
So you can't let no man, you don't know these brothers, man. You don't know these guys, man. A lot of you guys, y'all don't know what these men are really about. You just seen these guys since 2007-08, whenever it is you came in. You don't know what was going on since mid-90s, mm-hmm. mid-80s, all the way up until now. You don't know what these men have been taught and what they've been given or what deals they've taken. Because at this point, man, if you're watching this lesson and you're realizing that you've been taught wrong and you've been going off, you need to examine if you need to even be with these men.
That's
you
right.
need to examine if you need to be claiming a GMS or Great Millstone at this point. Because mm-hmm. I tell you right now, a lot of you brothers that are going to desire to want to move forward and go through with the baptism, you're not going to be able to do that staying with those men.
That's right.
You better believe that, man. You know, you brothers are going to have to leave and get with like-minded brothers to follow through in the steps and be with real men that truly fear the Lord, man.
Yep, because GMS is a spiritual roadblock to baptism, man.
Major.
Mm-hmm.
IUIC.
Yep.
ISUPK and other groups that have broken off that have not yet examined these things. And we had to examine these things.
That's right.
You know, because even when I was... You know, when we were in the camp, we never really went into baptism,
right?
You know what I'm saying? We never did any lessons on it. We never went into it really on the block or anything like that. But when we left, we had to start saying, we got to examine every aspect of the doctrine. And this was a major, major roadblock, spiritual stumbling block that was set before a lot of men. And now, hey, you guys over there, man, you think you guys got 100% truth? Hey.
You don't.
You don't, man. Hey, GMS, Yesidians DMV, you know who you are. Dost thou still have 100% truth? Hey, GMS Fear the Most High 7, Awabra Kwam, dost thou still have 100% truth? Hey, Yashawamba, Ariyala, all you guys, all you top teachers of Great Millstone, Nate, over at IUIC, Deacon Yawasat, Ayathun, are y'all preaching the right thing?
Mm-hmm.
All right? Yohana, all these different men, what are y'all teaching?
Right.
Because if y'all can't answer these questions, hey, if you guys can't come up with no response, a proper response, and examine why were these apostles of Yahushua who were with them, were they going off? We brothers need to know these things. Were they going off? Was Philip going off? Was Peter going off? Was Paul going off? Were all these men going off? You have to answer these questions.
Right. This is Luke 7 and 29. And all the people that heard him and the publicans justified the Most High being baptized with the baptism of John. But the Pharisees and lawyers rejected the counsel of the Most High against themselves, being not baptized of him.
Come on, bro. Read that verse 30 again, Ob.
But the Pharisees and the lawyers rejected the counsel of the Most High against themselves.
Against themselves, bro.
Being not baptized of him.
And what are those? Those same men. Those same men that did that will be back today rejecting the counsel of Yahweh against themselves and will not be baptized.
They're gonna die in their sins.
Yep.
That's right.
Because see, the Most High is not to be mocked. You think you're gonna, you, no man is gonna get away with that stuff from 2,000 years ago and come back now and try and get back in this thing if they didn't want to accept Yahweh Shai back then when he was around. Mm-hmm. How much more when he's not here?
Right, exactly.
You know? So, hey, you brothers and sisters, examine yourself. Are you, like these men, rejecting the counsel of Yahweh against yourself and not being baptized? Are you in that same lot? Well, that's something you're going to have to do, and you have to answer amongst yourself. So, hey, again, you know, hopefully this is edifying. If you have any comments to say, feel free to put it in the comment section.
It's more to come, too, after this.
Yeah, there's more to the beginning. This is only the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
But again, just like we say, if you don't have the answer, put your hand upon your mouth. Don't look silly. You're going to be right. Kicking up against the pricks.
That's right.
All right? So we want brothers to understand that this is really for edification. We had to examine ourselves. Just like now, it's your turn. The ball's in your court. What you going to do with it? So again, we want to give all praises and glory to Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahushai, and peace and blessings to you, brothers and sisters, throughout the four corners of the earth that are waiting on the second coming from our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai. Shalom. Shalom.